see today's racing action. All right, folks, here we go with qualifying. First out on the track out of Forest, Virginia. In that Mastersville race car powered by Vic Hill Racing Engine, this is the 87 of Walker Arthur. Walker Arthur, again in a Mastersville race car. Vic Hill Racing Engine on the hood, making his first laps of the season here at 411 Motor Speedway. First lap, 14.813, 14.813. Car sponsored by Cecil Arthur Beef Farm, All About Wraps and Walnut Ridge Kennels. Walker Arthur coming around for his second lap. And it's a little bit slower at 14.875. So Walker Arthur gets it started out with a lap of 14.813. Next car up, young man out of Virginia. And for some reason, not getting up to speed. And we'll see what's going on with that. So the four car, Mark Sturgill, pulls off of the track. Next up, the Boo Crew out of Newport, Tennessee. This is the B00 of Josh Henry. Josh Henry in a TNT race car, sponsored by Henry Chucking. Josh Henry, a second-generation driver. First lap for Josh Henry, 14.862, 14.862. And second lap upcoming for Josh Henry. 14.928, 14.928. Second lap just a little bit slower for Josh Henry. Right now, no stranger to the high banks of 411 Motor Speedway. This is the Iceman, the 32 of Jason Manley. Jason Manley breaks the beam. He's in a CVR race car, Phantom race engine under the hood. Jason Manley coming down the front stretch for his first of two. First lap, 14.997, 14.997. That car is sponsored by M&M Properties, Dirty Shirts Tavern, and Cobb's Auto Parts. Jason Manley coming out of turn number four for his second lap. We'll see if it's quicker. And it's a little slower, 15.077 so far. The first lap quickest for our qualifier so far. Up next, it's the Newport Outlaw, the D00. This is Josh Driscoll. Josh Driscoll in the D00. Josh Driscoll's first lap, 15.188, 15.188. He's in a Stinger chassis, car sponsored by Tennessee Media Blasting. Second lap upcoming for Josh Driscoll, 15.156, 15.156. That second lap just a tick quicker for Josh Driscoll. Up next, out of Seymour, Tennessee, this is the 29er Rusty Ballinger. Rusty Ballinger in the 29. Ballinger behind the wheel of a Mastersville race car, TNN race engine under the hood of the black number 29. First lap for Ballinger, 14.851, 14.851. That second quickest so far. Car sponsored by Lowe's Auto Parts, Sullivan Sandblasting, and Rick's Handyman Service. Second lap for Rusty Ballinger, 14.830, 14.830. Walker Arthur still quickest in qualifying so far. Up next, out of Gatlinburg, Tennessee, they call him Chrome. This is the 51 of Mac McCarter. Mac McCarter in a CVR race car, Phantom race engine under the hood. Mac McCarter coming down the front stretch for his first lap, 14.975, 14.975. Car sponsored by McCarter Farms, Hidden Valley Cattle Farm, McCarter Lumber Company, and Matlock Decals. Second lap upcoming for Mac McCarter. 14.968, 14.968. That's third quickest so far for Mac McCarter. On the track now out of Norris, Tennessee, this is a 7 of William Overby. William Overby in the 7. Overby's first lap, 15-786, 15-786. Overby in a Rayburn race car. And the second lap up coming for William Overby. 15-910, 15-910. Up next, another veteran here at 411 Motor Speedway out of Seymour, Tennessee. This is a 23, a Lane Clifton. Lane Clifton in the 23. Three wheels that coming out of turn number four, coming down the front stretch for his first lap. 15-4-3-3. Clifton in a Mastersbilt chassis sponsored by Bill Cure Roofing, Clifton Construction, and ELC & Company. Second lap up coming for Clifton, 15-302, 15-302. A little quicker on that second lap. Up next, the car owned by Shane Yoder, normally driven by Shane Yoder. This is the 2 White Lightning, Ross White. Ross White in the 2 this afternoon. Coming down the front stretch for his first lap. 15-864, 15-864. That is a Mastersbilt chassis sponsored by Susan's Cleaning Services, Competition Race Equipment, and Kenny Ford Plumbing. Second lap up coming for Ross White. And it's quicker, 15-139, 15-139 for White Lightning, Ross White. Next up, out of Seymour, Tennessee, this is the 31 of Brad Siegel. Brad Siegel. And Brad Siegel's first lap, 14-987, 14-987. A Stinger race car sponsored by Corky's Hardwood, Baker's Transmission, Julian Sheet Metal, and CFI Insulation. Brad Siegel coming down for his second lap, and it's a little slower at 15-261, 15-261. Walker Arthur still with the fastest lap so far. Next up, this is the double zero of Reuben Mayfield. Reuben Mayfield at the double zero. First lap for Reuben Mayfield, 14-950, 14-950. Good lap. Second lap, 15-368. Quite a bit slower on that second lap for Reuben Mayfield. All right, up next to qualify, and this is the A1 of Rick Hickson. Rick Hickson in the A1 machine. Rick Hickson's first lap, 14-745. That is your new quick time. Rick Hickson with new quick time, 14-715. We'll see if he's any quicker on the second lap in that CVR race car, sponsored by AAA Towing, and he's a little bit slower on that second lap, but the A1 of Rick Hickson, your fast qualifier so far. Up next, in that familiar number 52, that is the 52 in the Stinger race car of Ryan King. Ryan King in the 52. Ryan King's first lap, 14-495. There is your new quick time, folks. 14-495 for Ryan King in that Stinger race car. We'll see if he's any quicker on this second lap. And he's a little slower, but that's enough. So Ryan King on top. Up next to qualify, out of Barberville, Kentucky, this is the 7 of Brian Smith. Brian Smith in a Masters-built race car. Has taken the last couple of years off. And back behind the wheel of a dirt late model. Brian Smith out of Barberville, Kentucky, coming around for his first of two. First lap, 15.355, 13.355. Second lap upcoming for Brian Smith, 15.208, 15.208. That second lap, a little bit quicker. Next up, this is the 37 of Michael Barnett. Michael Barnett in the 37. Barnett's first lap, 15.280. 15.280. I'll have one more. Second lap for Barnett. And it's a little slower at 15.613. 15.613 for Michael Barnett. On the track now to qualify, the 119 of Josh Evans. Having a little bit of trouble with the handling, of course, that front end gone. No downforce whatsoever on the front end of the 119 car. First lap for Josh Evans, 18.406, 406. And gets it quite a bit out of shape, folks. And doing a little bit of daredevil work there to 119 of Josh Evans. Again, the front end missing off the whole front end of that car with no downforce whatsoever. All right, folks, on the track now. This is the 23 of Corey Hedgecock. Corey Hedgecock, your most recent winner here at 411 Motor Speedway. Won the hangover last month out of Loudoun, Tennessee. And a rocket chassis Eagle Race engine under the hood. Corey Hedgecock coming by for his first of two. 14.765. 14.765. That car is sponsored by KMP Used Cars, Total Communications, and Townsend Construction. Corey Hedgecock, your most recent winner. His second lap, 14.557. 14.557. That is second quickest time for Corey Hedgecock. On the track now, the blue and white 16, that is Danny French. Danny French in the 16. And French's first lap, 18.075, 18.075. Thunder and lightning need to be lining up. Thunder and lightning need to be lining up. So it looks like Danny French will not get a second lap in. And so the next car out looks like the last car out. This is the 4H of Levi Hicks. Levi Hicks in the 4H. Built race car sponsored by Bateman Trucking, Levi's Lawn and Landscaping, and Camel's Construction. Levi Hicks coming around for his first of two. First lap for Hicks, 15.335, 15.335. And that looks like it. So started on the inside, the front row on the pole for this heat race. That'll be the A1 of Rick Hickson alongside the 29 of Rusty Ballinger. Second row will be the 00 of Reuben Mayfield alongside the 31 of Brad Siegel. Third row will be the T6. So the inside of the third row, the T6 of Todd Hernandez alongside the D00 of Josh Driscoll. Fourth row will be the 37 of Michael Barnett. And he'll go up alongside the 4H of Levi Hicks. And starting on the last and final row, National Dirt Late Model Hall of Fame member, folks, and I'm not trying to play favorites, one of my all-time favorite drivers out of Chattanooga, Tennessee. They call him the Chattanooga Flash, the 5 of Ronnie Johnson. Yep. The 4H of Levi Hicks and the 5 of Ronnie Johnson. Six lap heat. The winner of this race will start on the inside of the second row.
Brent, settle down. Here's a good race.
One to go, signal in the air, looking for green next time by Rick Hickson. Rusty Ballinger on that front row. They'll be looking for the green this time by. And we are underway. First late model heat. Rick Hickson jumps out to lead. Battle for that second spot between Reuben Mayfield and Rusty Ballinger. They both dive down low. Everybody trying to jockey for position. Rick Hickson will lead the first lap. 3-car length advantage over 29 of Rusty Ballinger. Reuben Mayfield holds on to the third spot. Now Brad Siegel, he'll move to the inside of Reuben Mayfield, going down the back stretch, trying to take that third spot away. Two laps down, it's Rick Hickson followed by Rusty Ballinger, Reuben Mayfield, Brad Siegel, Todd Hernandez, Josh Driscoll, Levi Hicks, Ronnie Johnson, and Michael Barnett. First time today Ronnie Johnson have any kind of laps on this track. The dirt late model master right now trying to figure out what that master's built race car needs to move him toward the front. Halfway down, Rick Hickson, your leader. Rusty Ballinger, second. Reuben Mayfield holding on to that third spot. Again, the winner of this heat race will start on the inside of the second row of the 52-lap feature. White flag in the air for Rick Hickson. Ballinger still holding on to that second spot. Brad Siegel still putting pressure on Reuben Mayfield for the third spot. Checkered flag in the air for Rick Hickson as Brad Siegel gets out of shape coming out of four. He'll lose several spots. So Rick Hickson goes flag to flag to pick up that win. He'll start on the inside of the second row. Rick Hickson, your winner. Rusty Ballinger in second. Reuben Mayfield third. Todd Hernandez looks like he'll be scored fourth, followed by Josh Driscoll. And so Ronnie Johnson, first laps today. Track on the inside of the front row out of Forest, Virginia, just outside of Roanoke. That is the 87 of Walker Arthur. On the outside of Newport, Tennessee, it's the B00 Josh Henry. Second row on the inside will be the 51 of Mac McCarter. On the outside will be the 32. That'll be the 32 of Jason Manley. Third row on the inside, it'll be Ross White waving to the crowd in the black number 2. On the outside, out of Barberville, Kentucky, that is the 7 of Brian Smith. Fourth row, the 23 car, Lane Clifton. On the outside, the 7 car, William Overby. And on the last and final row will be the 119 of Josh Evans. And also looks like Lynn Birchfield will line up alongside him on that last and final row. So the winner of this six-lap heat will start on the outside of the second row. Again, Forest, Virginia's Walker Arthur won just a few weeks ago down at the Super Bowl of Racing at Golden Isle Speedway. Picked up the win in the Naismith Series. So good to have that young driver here with us. He's lined up alongside one of the brightest young stars out of East Tennessee, the B00 of Josh Henry. So again, Walker Arthur, Josh Henry on that front row, Matt McCarter, and Jason Manley on that second row, Ross White, Brian Smith in the third row, Lane Clifton, and William Overby in the fourth row, and Josh Evans and Lynn Birchfield will bring up the fifth and final row. Six lap heat. Field will get the one to go signal as they come by. Many stocks need to be getting ready for your heats. Many stocks need to be getting ready. All right, folks, here we come. As they go into turn number three, come around for the green flag, Walker Arthur, Josh Henry on that front row. Henry gets a good jump as they come down the front stretch. Walker Arthur dives down low. There's Jason Manley. He gets up into the mix. He goes to the outside of Walker Arthur, trying to take that second spot. Coming down the front stretch, complete lap number one. Josh Henry leader, contact between Manley and Arthur. Arthur got sideways for just a moment, straightens it back up. Manley will take over second. Walker Arthur not giving up. As they come down the front stretch, the complete lap number two, Josh Henry your leader, Jason Manley in second. Walker Arthur third, Mac McCarter fourth, and Ross White your top five. Now Jason Manley starting to put some pressure on the back of Josh Henry. They both dive low, go down turn number one. Walker Arthur, he's still there in that picture. Three laps down, coming around to complete lap number four. Josh Henry, your leader. Jason Manley in second. Walker Arthur in third. Good heat we got going on right here. Coming down the front stretch to take the white flag. Josh Henry, your leader. Now Walker Arthur dives down inside to take, trying to take that second spot away from Jason Manley. Checks up just a little bit. Manley in second, going down the back stretch, and we've got a spin over in turn number four. So again, you see that damage to the right rear of the 87 Walker Arthur. He got together with Jason Manley back on the first lap. And look for this to be a wild finish right here, folks. Looking for the green. This will be a green and white. So green checker. So again, they'll take the green, and that will be the final lap. Here they come out of turn number four, your last lap in your late model heat. Looks like Arthur going to try to go to the outside of Jason Manley. They go. He goes to the outside, door to door with Jason Manley. Coming out of turn number four, has he got enough to take that second spot? And he does. Walker Arthur, instead of taking the inside, goes to the outside of Jason Manley. And folks, what a great finish that was. Josh Henry takes the win. Walker Arthur goes to the outside of Jason Manley as they went down the back. Everybody on the track, and we'll get ready for your 52 laps, Sweetheart 52, $2,052 on the line to win. And there's your pole sitter, Ryan King, in that 52 car in honor of the original Superman, Scott Sexton. He's got that painted up as Scott would have had several years ago. English Mountain spring water on the hood, True Value hardware on the side. And as the field takes under green, we're going to do a missing man formation. And in honor of our old friend Scott Sexton, we'll do the missing man formation. And we'll give the honorary pull to Scott Sexton. All right, again, folks, we get the field bunched up. Again, Ryan King on that front row alongside the 23-year-old Corey Hedgecock. Second row will be the A1 of Rick Hickson alongside the B00 of Josh Henry. Third row is the 29 of Rusty Ballinger and the 87 of Walker Arthur. Fourth row is the 00 of Reuben Mayfield alongside the 32 of Jason Manley. Next row back, it's the T6 of Todd Hernandez and the 2 of Ross White. Then it's the D00, Josh Driscoll, and the 51 of Mac McCarter. On back is the 31 of Brad Siegel alongside the 7 of Brian Smith, who has yet to rejoin the field. No, he has rejoined the field. Then it's the 4H of Levi Hicks, the 23 of Lane Clifton, the 5 of Ronnie Johnson, the 7 of William Overby. Then it's the 37 of Michael Barnett, the 4 of Lynn Birchfield, and the 119 of Josh Evans. Again, as the field come by, folks, if you will, let's stand up and give a hand for the Mesa Man formation in honor of Scott Sexton. Now Ryan King pulls up into the pole position. Field gets the one-to-go signal. Ryan King, Corey Hedgecock on that front row. They've been so many times here. Wave at the field, folks, as they come by. Next time by, they will be looking for the green flag. 52 laps, $2,052 to win. Here we go, folks. Ryan King, Corey Hedgecock. Good even start. Here they come. Corey Hedgecock goes to the outside, takes the lead going down the back stretch. Cars jockeying for position, a lot of dust here. Ronnie Johnson passes about 3 cars on the back stretch. One lap down, Corey Hedgecock your leader, Ryan King second. Rick Hickson falls into the third spot. Josh Henry fourth, Walker Ark. Three-way battle going on for that fifth spot. Three laps in the books. Corey Hedgecock, your leader. 3 or 4 car length advantage over second place. Ryan King, drivers right now trying to get into a rhythm, trying to find which groove works for them. Tire selection, a big factor in today's race. 4 down to Corey Hedgecock, leading the way. Ryan King in second. Rick Hickson in third. Josh Henry fourth, and Walker Arthur fifth. Corey Hedgecock's got lap traffic up ahead of him as he goes into turn number 3. Before, Lynn Birchfield will be the first car to go a lap down. Hedgecock easily goes by him. Now he's up on the back bumper of Josh Evans, trying to get him to move over. Easily now gets around Josh Evans. Ronnie Johnson now moving up to the 15th spot. Working on the 23 of Lane Clifton. Working his way up through the field. Lots of laps left, folks. And we've got a spin over in turn 1 and 2. Turns 1 and 2. Let the drivers get a little bit of the breather. And he will do the Dixie double file restart. Corey Hedgecock trying to make it 2 in a row as he won the hangover here last month. Several feature wins here at 411 Motor Speedway's home track. Race is not over, folks. Just 9 laps down. Again, Ryan King in second. He'd love to win that in honor of Scott Sexton. Rick Hickson holds on to third. Josh Henry fourth, and Walker Arthur in fifth. Here they come around looking for the green. And we're back underway. Rick Hickson now tries to go after Corey Hedgecock, and we got a spinner down in turn number 2. Josh Henry gets turned the wrong way, didn't see what happened, but that will bring out the caution. All right, folks, field gets the one to go signal. Corey Hedgecock, your leader. Ryan King in second. Rick Hicks in third. Ryan King, the second place starter, he chooses to go to the outside of the second row, and we'll see if that works to his advantage as they come around three. Looking for the green this time by. So Ryan King took that outside line, got a little loose over in turn number two, and all of a sudden he has been moved back into the fourth spot. Rick Hickson moves in the second. Rusty Ballinger coming. He now moves into the third spot. Ronnie Johnson picking his way. He's sitting down about 10th or 11th. Lots of laps left. 11 down. Corey Hedgecock, your leader. Rick Hickson in second. Rusty Ballinger third. Ryan King fourth. And Walker Arthur in fifth as once again. It looks like the 119 of Josh Evans once again involved in that one, along with the 4 of Lynn Birchfield. And it looks like Josh Evans may call it a night. Track officials getting owned by Shane Yoder, or Danny Yoder owns that. Shane Yoder drives it. That Masters-built race car. Field gets the one to go signal. Looking for green next time by. Ronnie Johnson now moving up into the 11th spot, about halfway through the field. We're back under green. Rick Hickson trying to push the pressure on Corey Hedgecock. Hedgecock pulls away. Leading every lap so far. We've got a lot of racing left to do. 12 down, Corey Hedgecock, your leader. Hickson in second, Ballinger third. Walker Arthur now goes up into fourth. Cut a little bit of contact between Mac McCarter and Ryan King. Sees Mac McCarter spinning over in turn number two. So that'll bring out the caution once again. So just a little bit. All right, bunch of the field back up. Rick Hickson, your second place car. He'll go to the inside of the second row as the rest of the field follows suit. Again, Corey Hedgecock leading every lap so far. Lots of racing left to do. And so Josh Henry, who had started on the outside of the second row, moved all the way back toward the end of the field. Back underway, Rick Hickson once again trying to get some traction down low to gain some ground on your race leader. Brian Smith goes high over turn number two. Keeps it going straight. We're still underway. 13 down. Corey Hedgecock leading every lap so far. Rick Hickson in second. Rusty Ballinger third. Now Ryan King hanging on to that fourth spot. Walker Arthur moves to his inside as they come out of turn number four. Ryan King will hold on to that fourth spot. Ronnie Johnson, the Chattanooga Flash, after starting deep in the field, has moved his way up into the eighth spot. Up front It's all Corey Hedgecock with about a 7-car length advantage over second place Rick Hixon. 18 laps down, Corey Hedgecock with the advantage so far. Rusty Ballinger in third. Ryan King hanging on to that fourth spot. Then it's Walker Arthur, Ross White, Todd Hernandez, and Ronnie Johnson methodically trying to work his way up to the top. Now Corey Hedgecock gets his way up into lap traffic, pulling up on the back of, it's like Liam Birchfield, as Brad Siegel, he goes pit side after having problems early. Now Corey Hedgecock working lap traffic, coming up on the back bumper of Brian Smith. Brian Smith and Wim Overby, they're fighting for position. Corey Hedgecock's trying to get by as Rick Hixon now closes that gap between first and second. Hedgecock puts a couple of cars between him and second place Rick Hixon. 22 down, 30 more to go. So now Corey Hedgecock once again coming up on the back bumper of Brian Smith. Brian Smith now in a battle with Michael Barnett for position. Smith will back off and he'll let Corey Hedgecock go to the outside going down the back stretch. Michael Barnett, he gets the layover flag. The leaders are coming. Michael Barnett goes wide over in two. And still holding off Corey Hedgecock. Now Hedgecock will go to the inside coming out of four and trying to get around that lap car. Put some distance between him and Rick Hixon. Brian Smith, the 7 car out of Barberville, Kentucky, he pulls pit side with problems. 25 down, it's been all Corey Hedgecock so far. Weaving his way through lap traffic, Rick Hixon in second. Rusty Ballinger in third. Now Walker Arthur, he goes to the inside of Ballinger down in turn number two, trying to take that spot away from him. Halfway down, Corey Hedgecock's junior leader. Rick Hixon in second. Now Walker Arthur, he's going down the back stretch. He takes third away from Rusty Ballinger. Right now, smooth sailing for Corey Hedgecock as he got into a little bit of lap traffic. The next car to go a lap down will be the B00 of Josh Henry. And Hedgecock about 6 car lengths for pulling up on the back bumper of Josh Henry. So good job so far by Corey Hedgecock, leading the race and working his way through traffic. Hedgecock comes by 30 laps on the board, 22 more to go. Now Rick Hixon starts to gain a little ground as Corey Hedgecock goes into turn number 3, coming up on the back bumper of Josh Henry. Henry will go wide, maybe give him a little bit of room. Henry gets the layover flag. He's not going to do it easily. Hedgecock slows up just for a moment. Hedgecock with the advantage going down the back stretch, but when they come into turn number 1, that's where Rick Hixon catches up. And we've got a car up on the outside wall in turn number 4, and that will bring out the caution. Looks like the B00 didn't hit the wall, but he slowed as he came out of turn number 4. Now he gets it back underway. And that will bring us to another caution. All right, folks, bunch the field back up. Rick Hixon, the second place car, he'll go to the inside of the second row. Corey Hedgecock brings them out, looking for the green. Ron- Johnny Johnson moving all the way to bottom, almost made it four wide as they went down at turn number one. He's trying to move his way to the front. Ronnie Johnson was holding on to the eighth spot, now moves back to ninth. Corey Hitchcock up front, Rick Hickson in second, Walker Arthur third, Rusty Ballinger fourth, and now Todd Hernandez takes that fifth spot away from Ryan King. Down. It's all Corey Hitchcock up front. Rick Hickson trying to find any kind of line he can to catch up to the 23 car. Walker Arthur, he's happy to hold on to third. Rusty Ballinger fourth. Todd Hernandez, your top five. Laps down, 12 more to go. Still Corey Hitchcock up front as he puts William Overby a lap down. Has put a distance between him and second place car Rick Hickson, who's starting to have his bumper full of Walker Arthur. Lap's starting to wind down. 45 down. Corey Hitchcock putting it up. Rick Hickson in second. Now he's trying to get through lap traffic while he holds off a challenge from Walker Arthur, who's backed off just a little bit. Rusty Ballinger still in fourth. Todd Hernandez holding on to fifth. Five to go at the stripe. Corey Hitchcock hanging on. He'll come up on the back bumper of the 23 of Lane Clifton. May put him down a lap before the race is over with. Five more to go. Three more laps to go for Corey Hitchcock out of Loudoun, Tennessee. And that rocket chassis Eagle race engine under the hood. Corey Hitchcock's car is sponsored by Townsend Construction, Total Communications, K&P used cars. As he's working to put Lane Clifton a lap down, he just wants to hold on for two more laps. Corey Hitchcock, your leader. Rick Hickson in second, Walker Arthur third. And it's Rusty Ballinger in fourth, Todd Hernandez fifth. White flag in the air for Loudoun, Tennessee's Corey Hedgecock. Half a lap to go to make it two in a row here at 411 Motor Speedway.
I'll be right back.
I'll be over back in a minute.
You're welcome.
Sweetheart 52 out of Loudoun, Tennessee. Two in a row for Corey Hedgecock. Not a bad way to start off the 2014 season. You're two for two. And the car absolutely looked perfect out there today, Corey.
Yeah, it was honestly real good. Dad sets up the car, and I told him what it was doing as much as to my knowledge. And he watches real good, and he tunes and nits and picks on it, and there ain't a single shock on this car or spring, the same as when we showed up to the racetrack this week.
And, of course, you qualified second. Ryan King there on the pole. You guys are familiar up there. And then right from the start, you took off. It looked like you were coming out of two was really where you were strong coming off there. I know when you all came into one, that's where Hickson kind of closed in the gap. But coming out of two, this rocket race car was like a rocket.
Hey, I was trying to just baby it in there. That way I keep it good and straight coming up off the corner. Straighter these things are, the more traction they got. So, yeah, I know I was maybe giving a little bit getting in, but I was just making sure I was coming off good.
Now, that Eagle race engine had a lot to do with that coming off that corner.
Shoot, yeah. It was way overpowered, though, tonight for sure.
And, again, we talked to some of the other drivers this new configuration, and what did you think about it?
It was it'll be a lot more racier tonight, really. I mean, he did good. I mean, a whole new dirt and everything. I know it's hard to do, and I'm because I'm not a dirt worker. But yeah, the racetrack's a lot more better lettered out. Yeah, if he gets the maybe bottom worked in a little bit better and slicker up on top, and yeah, I think it'll be real racy.
You're itching to get back here for a night race, aren't you?
Yeah, I'm tired of watching the sun coming down the back straightaway. It's blinding me.
And just how we saw that, and there's a lot of dust. Just how much sun was it coming out of turn number two?
It was terrible. The cautions, I mean, I hate the cautions because I like to just keep my tires warm and keep on going, but get the race over with. But I was praying for cautions. That way the sun could get going down because I couldn't. My dad's standing over there around the victory lane, and I couldn't see how far I was ahead of everybody, and all the dust and everything, and I couldn't really tell you where I was at going on the back straightaway.
Thank you, sponsors, before we go.
Yeah, let me thank Eagle Racing Engines, Total Communications, Stealth Racing Carburetors, Solana New, Renegade Race Fuels, K&P Used Cars, ET Motor Gear, Timeless Members Photography, MikeAgena.biz, Scotty Evans. Anybody that helps on this thing week in, week out, and Hunter, my buddy over there, helps me wash it every Sunday. Mom, Dad, and girlfriend Katie, everybody.
And you remembered everybody. Folks, one more time, it's here for your winner to the Sweetheart 52 out of Loudoun, Tennessee, Corey Hedgecock.
Cover the medical bill.